Hello, mic test. We've got more than 5,000 as our profit here. The total percent profitability is more than 90% in this case. The profit factor is more than 6 actually. The drawdown is also very limited now. It's 35% only. And it looks like a very, very good strategy here. Hello, financial programmers. I'm Pritvik Dashura and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. In the last video, we talked about tilted RSI strategy, right? And it gave quite a decent output. In this one, we are going to make another strategy which will be using Bollinger Bands. And again, this particular indicator, which is Bollinger Bands, is used a lot in the industry because it's one of the most used technical indicator, especially for the support and resistance level. But we also know that it is not a very good indicator to make profitable trades, right? So we have to upgrade it, right? So that's why I am making this video with a new strategy called drifted Bollinger Bands. If you are new to my YouTube channel, then guys, on this channel I make videos on pine script trading bots, implementation of AI in finance using some highly valuable finance APIs, etc. So if this is something that you are interested in, then you should click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more trading strategies that are coming on this YouTube channel for free. So let's see what are all the topics that we are going to cover before writing this code. So yes, we are making drift Bollinger Bands trading strategy. Now what it is, basically what we'll be doing is we will be focusing on three different things here. It's like a triple confirmation, right? The first one is normal Bollinger Bands indicator. The second one is creating a trend filter. And the third one is creating a volatility filter. So basically I am actually planning to pick the best upward or downward trend and using the volatility, which is the standard deviation, such that the higher the standard deviation, the greater the possibility of that particular trend. And that's why the name is drift Bollinger Bands, because drift means trend, right? So I'm just focusing on different trends and using Bollinger Bands support and resistance level to maximize the profit, right? So if all the condition satisfies for buy, we'll create a long position, and the same thing happens for sell, we'll create a short position. We'll also make stop loss and trailing profit in order to optimize the strategy as much as possible. But before everything, guys, it's a disclaimer. This is not an investment advice. Please do your own research before making any trading decision. This is just made for educational purpose. Okay, so this is the Pine editor here. Now let's start with our coding for the strategy. So this is how we start. We will mention that it's version 5 strategy drift Bollinger Bands strategy overlay is equal to true, because we want to put the plot on the main graph here. The initial capital is $1,000. Now let's do one thing. The first thing is mentioned over here. You can see we will use the Bollinger Bands indicator, right? So let's create one, right? Bollinger Bands. So suppose BB length is an input, right? So let's provide it as an input, input.integer, and say it's 14, right? And title is length. We are grouping every like different types of inputs in just one segment, which is Bollinger Bands here, right? Second input is on BB standard deviation, right? So here I'll just provide input.float, and then I've provided some numbers here. So the standard deviation, for example, in this case, it's 2.1, right? Title is std dev, which is standard deviation, and it's a part of the same group, which is Bollinger Bands, right? Now, in order to calculate the Bollinger Bands, we'll just write ta.bb, right? Inside this, just provide close, and then bb length, comma, bb standard deviation, right? Now this will throw us three different outputs, so we'll have to provide three different variables here. So let's just provide blank or underscore in the beginning, because that belongs to the middle one. I am not interested in that. Upper and lower, right? These are the upper and lower bands. This is how it will be created. So before doing anything, let's just plot the upper and the lower bands here, right? If I just save it here, right, it will ask me to save it, like give a script name. Let's just keep this one only and add to chart. Of course, there's no strategy, there's no order here because we have not yet placed any order. So this is the Bollinger band, right? The upper one and the lower one. Perfect. Let's change the color of these two plots, right? I like aqua, which is the color of my website as well, which is fpritvik.com. I'll talk about my website in much detail in some time. So yeah, let's continue. Now the buy condition for BB which is Bollinger Bands, is equal to TA dot crossover, right? The close should be crossing over the upper. And the same goes with the cell condition, BB is equal to TA dot cross under close comma lower. Right. So that's the condition. That's the first condition that we have met, right? Which is Bollinger Bands. Now, the second one, as per our strategy, the second one is creating the trend filter, right? The third one would be volatility. So trend filter. Now, the reason I'm focusing on trend filter is because, as the name suggests of this particular strategy, which is drift Bollinger Bands, I am focusing on the trend and using the Bollinger Bands. So in order to understand the trend, I think the easiest to understand indicator is EMA, which is exponential moving average. So let's first provide some inputs, which is the first one is the period input dot integer. And let's say period is 365 in last 1 year. So simple by condition trend would be close should be greater than TA dot EMA, which is exponential moving average of close comma trend period. Simple. And the cell condition goes similar to this one only, which is close should be less than TA dot EMA close comma trend period. So this is how we are confirming the trend, right? Now, as I mentioned here in the topics to cover, the third one is volatility filter. The main reason I'm actually putting it here is because I have seen in the market that whenever there is a trend and if there is a very high volatility, then there is a good possibility of getting a very high up or the downward moves in single candles, right? And those candles are very, very good opportunity for us to make some short-term trades, right? So that's why the higher the volatility, the better it is in this case. So I am actually long on volatility. I'm bullish on volatility in this case. Before writing the volatility filter here, I have a quick information to you guys. Guys, I have recently launched my course on Python for financial programming, which is specifically made for people who are interested to learn Python from scratch. And the link is in the description box, which is fpritvik, which is financial programming with rithvik.com/python, right? Over here, you will see two buttons, Indian candidates, non-Indian candidates. So you can click as per your location. It will redirect you to this, the main website where the entire course information is available. You'll see that there are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes and 3 assignments with 2 live projects. And this is the entire syllabus of this course for all the people who are interested to learn Python from scratch and who are struggling learning Python on their own. I highly recommend it because it's very, very affordable and I have covered a lot of things from a very, very simplistic eyesight. And in the end, in session 4 and 5, you'll see stock analysis and investment portfolio creation projects, which are my personal projects. We did it using some financial analysis. If you use RTK40 code, you'll get an instant 40% discount, which is only available for the first 100 candidates. So yes, guys, I'll see you in the course. Let's come back to the code, right? So the third filter is volatility filter. Basically, I want to calculate the standard deviation here, but in order to calculate the standard deviation, I would be required to input the number of candles I'll consider to calculate it. Vol filter length is equal to input dot integer, the number of candles. So let's just write 15 as a default value. Title is length, volatility filter. This is the group. And the volatility filter, or just standard deviation, is equal to TA dot STD EV and then close comma the length. So it will calculate the standard deviation of it. Now we have to see whether the standard deviation is high or not. As I mentioned, I am interested in a higher standard deviation. I am interested in a high volatility here, right? So I'll compare it with its moving average, right? So let's create another input, which is vol MA length, because I want to have a length value for to calculate the moving average as well, dot int. So yeah, 28 comma title is greater than MA, because I want it to be greater than MA. And then yeah, this is again a part of the same group only. So let's create our by condition. So by condition vol is equal to the vol standard deviation should be greater than the TA dot SMA, right? Let's just do simple moving average of the same vol standard deviation and the length, which is vol MA length here. Right. Perfect. So I want it to be more than the moving average of the standard deviation. And actually, this is not just buy condition. I would call it buy sell condition here, because I want the volatility to be high for both buy and sell, because the trend can be in both a bullish way or a bearish way. In both the sense, I want volatility to be high. Right. Entry and exit condition. Guys, if you're not writing the code with me, it's absolutely fine. I'll tell you how you can get this particular code in some time. So yeah, let's continue with it and then I'll come to that point. So the buy condition final is equal to buy condition BB and buy condition trend and buy sell condition vol, right? Same goes with the sell condition final is equal to sell condition BB, sell condition trend and buy sell condition vol, right? That's it. Simple if logic, which is if buy condition final will provide a strategy dot entry. I think by now you guys are expert in this thing. Let's keep it long, and the same goes with if sell condition final strategy dot entry short. I have to write strategy dot long here and strategy dot short here. Now if the price crosses the support level, then in that case we will make an exit, make a close, then we will close that particular position. So we'll have to make a close condition here as well. Close condition long is basically sell condition BB, which is this one, right? Whenever there is a crossover, right, in that case it should be closing the long position, right? So I'm just using this condition right away here, as we have done it here, to close this thing. And similar to this, the close condition short is equal to buy condition BB, right? Now let's provide the close conditions. If close condition long, then I'll have to strategy dot close long, right? And the same goes with if close condition short strategy dot close and then short, right? Looks great, right? Let's run this. I still have to provide the stop loss conditions here, but let's see what is the final result. I think let's close this and add to the chart again. Perfect. We have already in a very good situation. The percent profitability is somewhere around 45%, right? We will have to increase it, which we will do, because we are yet to put the stop loss condition here. Definitely the drawdown will go down significantly. So let's come back to our Pine editor. Stop loss and trailing profit, right? So I am actually doing trail stop PCT. I'm providing a percent as an input to provide the stop loss condition, right? So input dot float, right? Suppose it's 0.5%, and I've just written the title is as trailing stop activation. It will exit long, right? There's a group, so the group is exit long, right? And then other information here. So what this particular thing will do is basically whenever there is a 0.5% movement, then it will activate the trailing stop condition. And then post that the stop loss will be trailing, right? So that's why this is 0.5. It will wait for this 0.5% move, right? But there's another thing in Tradingview, trail offset, right? So let me just open the Tradingview documentation for this, right? Here, yeah. So there's something called trail points and trail offset. This is something that we are going to use here. So the trail points, if we look here, it defines at how many instrument ticks of profit the trailing stop activates. When that profit amount is hit, the strategy.exit enables the trailing stop. So basically, as I mentioned earlier as well, in our case, it's 0.5%. So whenever there is a 0.5% of profit, it will activate the trailing stop condition, right? But in order to do this, the first point is once the trailing stop activates, it trails best price with the number of ticks. We configure that ticks amount with the trail offset argument. So there is another argument, which is trail offset, which is basically required whenever we provide this particular condition, which is trail points, right? So trail offset sets how many instrument ticks the trailing stop follows price. This is the distance between the best price and the trailing stop level, right? So basically they have given an example here. For long condition, trail offset places the trailing stop the given number of ticks below the highest price reached since the trailing stop activated, right? So for example, if it's say 0.5%, which is converted to say 300 ticks, so it will provide 300 ticks trailing stop below the highest level, right, since it was activated. And the same goes with the short condition as well, which will be considering the lowest price, right? And it will place it above the price, because in the short position it's the opposite, right? Again, if you want to read it, I will include this particular link in the description box for your more information. But let's come back to our code. So I have included another input here, which is a float input, which is offset, trail offset, right, which is also 0.5 in this case, right? And now I'm converting both of them into ticks, right? They were in percentage earlier. So 0.5 multiplied by close multiplied by 100, and this one as well. Now another two inputs that I have included here are stop loss and take profit percent. Again, they both are inputs, float inputs. In this case, I am just providing 2% and 9% as stop loss and take profit percent respectively. So we'll have to calculate the price for the stop loss and take profit levels for both the long and the short positions. Let's do it. Long SL price is equal to strategy dot position average price, which is the order price, current open order price, I would say, multiply by, because it's a long stop loss price, we'll have to reduce it, right? So 1 minus SLPCT divided by 100, because that is in percentage. We'll have to do the same thing for take profit as well. TP price is equal to, I'll just copy this exactly like this and then paste it here like this, plus this one would be TP, right? The same thing will be done for the short as well, like this one, right? I've done the same thing for the short position as well. So we have now stop loss and take profit price for both the long and the short positions. Now the last thing here is basically to open an exit position here, strategy.exit. So strategy.exit, and then just write, let's just do the long first, long position first, right? It will be from entry is basically long, right? Now the stop is this one, right? Limit is this one. Trail points, we have already calculated it, which is this one. And the last one, which is the trail offset, is equal to this one, right? So I'll just copy and paste it here. The same goes with the short exit as well. So strategy.exit, and then I'll just write here short exit, right? Comma, here is short, and then everything is like this one. So stop is basically short SL price. The limit is this one, right? Which is this one. Trail points is already calculated over there. Trail offset is also here. Let's save this particular script and go to the strategy tester. Perfect. So this is great. So we've got more than 5,000 as our profit here. The total percent profitability is more than 90% in this case. The profit factor is more than six actually. The drawdown is also very limited now. It's 35.39% only. It looks like a very good strategy. But again, guys, we have to do more research here, because this is something that I just created and it looks great. So yes, guys, if you like the video, then please also click on that like button, because it's very, very important. Also mention in the comment box if you have any particular strategy in your mind that I should cover. I will definitely try to do it in the next videos, because this entire playlist is just to make trading strategies on PineScript. I have planned 4 more strategies. I will not reveal the name of them as of now, but you'll have to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell icon to stay tuned to all those strategies. Now, how to get the Google Drive access. But yeah, before that, if you would like to give me some freelance work, then reach out to me on this email address. In order to get the Google Drive access, just go to my YouTube channel and click on that access to my Google Drive button. Follow all the steps that are present over there. You can see that the access to my Google Drive costs very, very small amount of money. I would say it's less than 1/3 of a coffee. And this particular code will be saved in that Google Drive. And not only this code, there are many more codes that are saved in that Google Drive, including my personal trading bot and a lot of study material. So definitely I am 100% sure that everything that I have kept on my Google Drive will be very, very helpful to you. That's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you'll see the entire playlist that I'm actually making for the trading strategies on PineScript. And over there you'll see the most recent video that I have uploaded on YouTube. Down below you'll see my website. You guys should definitely check it out. So yes, guys, in the next video I'll be talking about some other strategy, and till then, peace.